On the subject of controversial speakers, you might remember the controversy over Don Brash appearing at Massey University. Well, this week Don Brash went back and did speak on campus. Reporter Fiona Owen was there.
Security officers, police, and plain-clothed dudes with earpieces. ETA 1600. We want to be free. And on site, Dr. Don Brash.
Well, that was a very uneventful arrival on campus.
We've got a lot of security here today.
Jonathan Ayling is the head of the Free Speech Union.
Actually, everyday Kiwis are quite okay with us exercising our right to free speech, but there's a very small portion of people who try and shut these things down, and it's just really not on.
Back up to 2018, when Massey University shut Don Brash down. He was scheduled to speak. It was big news then, against a backdrop of the emerging culture wars. Trump was into his term, and far-right crusaders Southern and Molyneux were about to arrive here. People took to the streets against racism. Don Brash eventually got to speak at Massey, but 4 years on, it's a different dynamic again.
Basically here because I believe in free speech.
We also agree with what he says, and I'm Maori, so I don't find him to be racist at all, because if I did, I wouldn't be here.
The former leader of the opposition, Don Brash.
This was meant to be the third lecture in a free speech series, but last week AUT cancelled a talk that was to be given by Daphne Whitmore from Speak Up for Women.
Why was it cancelled at AUT?
Well, staff and students at AUT lobbied the administration to have us excluded 2 days before the event was held.
But AUT told Q&A that although it recognises the right of trade unions to host meetings for their members on campus, an event planned by the Free Speech Union had been advertised as a university lecture, and as a result, AUT cancelled the room booking.
So we changed it to a closed union meeting, and they still shut us out. Now, one of their inclusion managers was a little bit more honest on Facebook and said, look, the reason that this meeting has been cancelled is that some people believe Speak Up for Women is a hateful group.
Freedom of speech, freedom to say.
Back in Palmerston North, Dr. Brash has been challenged about his limits on freedom of speech.
I get the impression that you're a free speech absolutist. So could you say the N-word?
The N-word?
Because you're saying that you can argue that black people are inferior. To my earlier question, so can you say the N-word if you're...
No, I would not say the N-word under any circumstances. I think it's an insulting word.
So there are limits to free speech.
Don Brash traversed a range of subjects, misinformation, media control, and others with common themes. The treaty, Hapuapua, Three Waters, Mātauranga Māori.
Do you know what Mātauranga means?
Have my knowledge of it, you mean?
Yeah.
Very limited indeed. Very limited indeed.
You say on Hobson's pledge, it is through knowledge and understanding that we can move forward as one. I find that a bit of a contradiction, as you have no knowledge and no understanding of Mātauranga Māori.
It obviously doesn't concern you that to a chunk of New Zealanders, when you mention the name Don Brash, they do think racist. You know that, don't you?
Yeah, of course I do. And it irritates the hell out of me, quite frankly. I was brought up in an era when racial equality was absolutely fundamental. I lived for 5 years in the US during the height of the civil rights movement. I was there when Martin Luther King was assassinated.
Did you march?
I did. Well, let me qualify that. I was at that point on the staff of the World Bank. I was very tightly restricted in what I could. I couldn't even put a bumper sticker on. But I was very strongly committed to that civil rights movement.
The Free Speech Union claims to have 75,000 members and growing, and will be rolling out more speakers over the coming year.